So today I've been recording the Talking Therapy Ensemble, which is a new project of mine, completely different from my usual music. It's, I guess, a mix between free jazz, punky kind of stuff, and it's about just exercising demons and trying to find some catharsis. And, you know, we can talk about stuff that you might only talk about with like a therapist or something. So trying to blur that world that you have to do a lot as an artist of what's public, what's private, you know, how much of your personal life and your personal struggles are you going to use as fuel for your art? The Gatehouse felt really intimate. We all felt very held there, I think, because it's slightly away from the other studios. It sort of feels like its own little world where you can experiment and not feel like people are watching you. So that's quite nice to sort of be tucked away. I like to just first and foremost make sure the drum sound is right. That's the most important way that I like to sort of set up, because the drum sound kind of will infer everything else. So if the drums sound right and exactly how we need to, like in the pre-production, then everything else is going to go well. So on drums is Dougal Taylor, my sort of usual drummer and collaborator. Matt Gedrich on the bass, again, my sort of regular touring bassist. And Binka Golding on the saxophones, who is an incredible saxophonist. It was just a case of showing the guys the music. You know, they'd never seen it before. I'd sort of spoke to them about what I wanted in terms of the sound world, but they'd never seen the charts. I mean, it's very minimal sort of written sheet music. And I did that with my last record. No one knew the music before we recorded it. I wanted to sort of surprise people and have that sort of slight sense of hopefully wonder of like, okay, this is something brand new, and that excitement of playing something that you don't know. So you're always going to be fresh in the way you approach it. We were playing live together in a circle, everyone looking at each other, lots of eye contact. And we recorded things pretty much completely live. There's just been one or two little overdubs just to thicken up some sounds, but pretty much just a live performance, and it's been raw and real. Get writer's block. I think always being under pressure is really good for that, because you don't really have the time or the luxury to feel stuck. But also having, you know, done degrees in composition, I think what you learn from that is a toolkit of ways to approach things. So almost taking art into a place of like being a tradesperson. So it's like, okay, I have a job to do here, rather than waiting for this, you know, elusive muse that might never come. It's a sense of, you know, every day I'm writing down little ideas, little sketches. My ultimate advice is to trust yourself and to keep learning. So never feel satisfied that you know enough. Always be looking for new techniques, new ideas. Don't let people turn you away from your vision. If you have something in mind that you want to do, then you should wholeheartedly commit to that.